LBC Radio 1.
And good afternoon, 4:45, it's Greg James back off me jolly holidays, and it's nice to be back. I've got DJ Fresh to play for you in a second, Katy Perry as well, and after 5 o'clock, a brand new star caller. And it's a really good one today. It's, oh, they're always good, but this one is kind of, I think it might be the most pervy one we've ever had. That's just to let you know, after 5 o'clock today. More importantly, good afternoon, Danny from The Script.
Hey, hey, how are you, man?
I'm really good, thanks
You're
for popping in.
You're looking very, very brown today.
Thank you, it's real.
I need to go where you went.
It's real.
I'm so white, I look transparent, people can actually see what I'm thinking.
Quite ghostly.
Casper.
But how are you doing, you alright?
Really, really good, yeah. Today is the day we release our first single to radio.
Okay.
So from the album 3. It's a song called Hall of Fame, and it's featuring will.i.am.
We wanted to get you on to talk about all sorts of stuff.
Absolutely, yeah.
There's so much. Well, you've brought up the single. Let's talk about that first, because how did the collaboration... how did you meet will.i.am?
So how did it all take place? I mean, we were maybe a week away from finishing The Voice. I was playing Will maybe 5 or 6 songs from our new album, and he heard this one song, Hall of Fame.
Yo, that dope.
That's dope. That's dope, 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 dope.
That is dope. And, put me on that song. That is dope. I want some of that song.
I can put something on it.
What has he put on it?
He just he loved the lyrics, loved the song, loved the melody, and I was expecting him to maybe like want to write a verse for it or something, but he loved the lyrics and just jumped on and kind of took Mark actually originally sang Will's parts and then was like, let's do
Mark
it together,
it?
You know? Not at all, no, because they do this part in the middle 8, which is, it's great, it's like a big chanty part. You guys haven't heard it yet, so, you know, but everybody gets a look in, it's crazy. Even Mark, our guitarist, he's now singing on the record as well, so it's a new script.
Did he not go a little bit sort of, oh, come on, I can sing it better than will.i.am?
No, not at all.
He called himself Mark I Am.
Yeah. Mark Amini. Em and I, the Irish one. No, Mark's absolutely, like, we've always been fans of Black Eyed Peas, even since before Fergie was in it. You know, he had songs called, like, Request Line and, you know, jams that we lived in Orlando at the time. So it's an amazing full circle that's come around now that we've actually done something with him, you know.
Well, it's nice to have you back, and we're going to play it in a second. But I just want to talk a bit about The Voice and stuff as well.
Sure, yeah,
So much has been written and said about The Voice.
Of course.
Did you enjoy doing it? Did you love it?
Honestly, I had a lovely time. There's been, like, you know, in the press every day, it kind of goes back and forth. Are they not doing it? Are they? Personally, I would love to do it again. You know, I was talking to Will when we were shooting the video last week, and he's like, you know, are you doing it? And I'm like, I'd love to, absolutely. He's like, well, I'm not doing it if you're not doing it. So,
oh, like that, is it?
Yeah, kind of, yeah. It's like, okay. But I think it's, I heard reports today that maybe Jesse and Tom aren't.
I know, I was going to say.
People keep asking me about it.
Because I'm out of the loop. I saw a paper today. I saw an advert for the new... Right. The new series of Hollywood will be going, if you think you've got what it takes to be on The Voice, then you can be on it next season.
What about you? You reckon you could do it?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah? Do you want to try? You want to try right now?
I'd love to.
Go on, give us something. Give us a bar of like a script song or something.
I've got to turn around. Hang on.
You got to turn around. You got to turn around. You're going to press the ejector seat.
You're going to turn around?
Yeah, I'll turn around and then. Go on.
Okay.
Go on.
Okay.
Oh, hang on. Feedback.
Should I do a script song?
Yeah, do whatever you want, man.
Which one?
Just don't mess it up.
She's all left alone in an empty bed.
My head. What was that? Sounds like someone farting in a crisp packet.
She's all alone. What was it?
She's all laid up in bed with a broken heart.
That's the one, yeah. That's
the one. Well, I'm laid up in bed. Go on.
Okay,
keep going, go on.
I would have turned around for that.
Yeah, lovely.
So you want to come back for another series of The Voice?
I would love to, absolutely, yeah. If they had me back. But last time I had to sign a contract saying that I wouldn't curse on live television. So I stuck true to it this time, yeah.
Was that quite difficult for you?
It was, yeah, being Irish and, you know, being loud and proud and stuff, yeah.
I know, because the first time I met you in the live lounge.
Yeah.
And you were a potty mouth.
Was I, yeah?
Yeah, and I said, there'll be none of that on the air, please. This is the BBC. what's the story with Jesse and Tom, do you know?
No, I don't know. I just heard reports today that that both of them said they were out. But again, it kind of flip flops back and forth. So I'll wait till I see them. And
okay, cool. I really like Bo. I really like Bo.
Cool.
I was a big fan of Bo.
Brilliant voice.
Really
unique voice.
When she did the Coldplay song.
Yeah,
I like this.
Really great arrangement. I believe she met Coldplay, and Coldplay were like, "Yeah, we love the arrangement on the song as well."
And
so I was like taking a little pat in the back as well for that. We're like, "Nice."
Did you go? Chris, it's my idea.
Yeah, I have a song called Hall of Fame. You want to do it with me?
I did the arrangement.
Fob off, because will.i.am's doing it.
Let's play this new song then. This is the first play on Radio 1.
First play on Radio 1. Okay. Absolutely, yeah.
The Script featuring will.i.am. That is dope. It's out on the 2nd of September. It's called Hall of Fame.
Hall the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the hall. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
Script is brand new, it's called Hall of Fame.
BBC Radio 1.
And Danny from The Script is here.
I'm honestly, my heart was pounding at it because I always get really nervous when, you know, you're about to kind of present your baby to the world, you know, I'm like, oh, really nervous.
I like your baby. And stuff. It's not an ugly baby. It's good.
It's a big baby, it's a 12-pound, 8-ounce baby, but
I said that was a good nine. A good nine pound baby.
I appreciate that, thank you.
9 pound baby with a little bit of hair.
Came out with a tiny tuft.
A little tiny tuft that will grow into a lovely mane. That's a huge record.
Thank you. Yeah,
so you've got Will I Am on it as
well. It's a feel-good record, you know, and I think at the same time we release it on a good day. It's sunny outside, people have their windows rolled down.
For legal reasons, not sunny everywhere, because we'll get annoyed in Scotland.
Yeah, for legal reasons, they're going to sue me. But I mean, who would have known if Rihanna's single had been good, if it had been sunny on the day that she released Umbrella? Probably wouldn't have been as big a hit.
Actually, it was, you know, it was quite sunny because she was playing at our big weekend. And I remember she was like, it was number one on the day she performed.
Oh my God, sunshine and not an umbrella in sight.
Exactly. It was number one for the sunshine, obviously, like in China. So that's quite clever to release it around the Olympics.
Yeah.
Because is for the slow motion javelin bits and stuff. Like if someone falls over with a javelin, that would be perfect.
That was like
compliment.
Right there, Hall of Shame. So this,
you can just imagine.
The slow motion.
Yes, you're seeing Bolt.
Go.
Started 100 meters.
You can imagine it.
I was thinking it'd be a lot more fun if you went and you taped like a 6 or 7 year old's egg and spoon race and like all slow mode it, like it was a big like everybody's elbowing each other out of the way, real grimy black and white kind of a video, you know, it was like three legged race, the sack race, all the dads race later on, you know what I mean? be really cool. Someone out there, please do that. Edit that video and put it up on YouTube. That'd
well,
be
that's
great.
What, because the BBC's the official Olympic broadcaster. Yeah. That's what Channel 5 should do.
Yeah.
Just go and rock up someone's sports day and go, this is the real Olympics. We've got sort of like St. Joseph's Church of England School doing the egg and spoon race. That would be perfect. You've got some. Oh, do you want to hear some reaction? Do you want ego boost?
Yeah, yeah. Oof.
Livia Norwich. I love this song. It's my favourite song of the year. My favourite script song of all time as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks, Mom. Appreciate it.
Becca from Lyme Regis. Words cannot describe how much I love this. I've loved them since 2008. Hall of Fame is incredible.
Thank you.
Laura in Burnley. So, so happy that the scripts are back. Absolutely love this. And
thank
I love
you,
Danny,
Laura.
But that is another matter, she says in brackets. A bit stalkery there.
She's probably outside waiting for me.
Stalkers always do texts in brackets. So, you know.
See, the thing about stalking someone is you really need to do your homework, you know, see if you've had the same interests. You know, if they might go bowling, you hate bowling, it would suck, wouldn't it?
Please or don't give tennis tips out to stalkers on the air. It's awful.
For legal reasons. No.
Let's talk about the judges. I want to find out more about this judge, because the four of you was an amazing...
It's weird dynamic. Really amazing dynamic.
That shouldn't have worked, to be honest with you.
It sounded like a skit from The Simpsons originally when it was like, okay, it's going to be Tom Jones, Will.i.am, Jesse J, and you.
On paper, shouldn't have worked.
Yeah, but, you know, the chemistry that we had was unbelievable, you know. Still in contact with them all, and Tom's actually performing at a place called Marley Park in Dublin. And so I'm going to call him up literally after to say, "Is there any chance I can come out on stage with you? Be really good, you know."
I was going to say, are you all mates and stuff?
Yeah, of course, absolutely. Ever since the first day we had dinner, we've just been the best of friends. Yeah, we all went out and got hammered together and went out and had dinner, and me and Tom were there. We were talked about on the show before, but yeah, we went out and got a little bit too drunk. Swapping stories, you know, people were saying, so what do you say to Tom Jones? And I was like, nothing, you shut up and listen. You really do, you know.
To all the stories.
Yeah, magic stories.
I bet he's one of the best people to go for a drink with ever.
Yeah, yeah.
Unbelievable. So for the script then, you're full steam ahead with a new album and stuff. Is
that
all written and done?
We go straight into promotion. The album, it's called Number 3. If you're searching online, it's actually hashtag 3.
Hashtag trendy. Hashtags are trendy.
It's trending right now. It's trending right now.
Okay.
So, you know, there's three of us in the band. It's our third album. We recorded it in the Studio 3. You know,
with a man with three legs.
My birthday is October 3rd. So, like, we genuinely kind of, we love these omens. Our first album was released on the 8th of the 8th, 08. And it was a really good one as well.
And this is out on the 3rd of September.
Yep.
Very clever.
Very clever.
Have you got big tour and stuff coming up?
Yeah, massive tour coming up. We're now kind of, we got elevated up. It's really weird to say this because it was only maybe 2 years ago that we were kind of playing to like small, really small crowds. So now with the stadium tour on, we're going to release that, I think, just after the album. Just after the album, yeah.
It's really insane. Congratulations to you all, because that is massive. I remember speaking to you and you said that going back to the stadium gigs in Ireland, like the most amazing thing for you possible, because down the road, wasn't it, that the old pub that you started at was...
Yeah, I mean, within, I think the space of 2 years, we'd gone from playing maybe 26 people, and most of them were my family and friends, to 60,000 people. And it was literally within a quarter mile of itself, you know what I mean, from the first place we started to where it ended up at the end of the last album. We actually made a DVD out of it, the live at the Aviva in Dublin. And it's, you know, still the hair on the back of my neck stands up every time I think about it. Really amazing.
Well, thank you for popping in today.
Listen, thanks a million for playing it. You know, you've always been a big supporter of us as well. So I want to thank you guys in Radio 1 as well for...
That is our pleasure.
Always pumping the script.
Hall of Fame is the new script single. It features Will.i.am. You can get that on the 2nd of September. New album, hashtag 3.
Absolutely.
Out on the hashtag 3rd of September as well. Danny, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, Greg. See you soon.
Hey, ¿qué pasa? Soy el tío de la voz en español. A no ser que hables mi idioma, no estarás entendiendo ni papá.